Good afternoon, everybody. Please be upstanding for the graduating class of 2023, accompanied by their class tutors. You are all very welcome to this afternoon's celebration. Together we join our graduating class of 2023 as they reach the end of their secondary school education at Cláis na Cuarán. The well-known author Dr. Seuss once said, "You're off to great places. Today is your day. Your mountain is waiting, so get on your way." And that is the inspiration for today's theme. Today is your day. Our graduating class missed their junior cycle examinations due to the pandemic, experienced the start of online classes, arrived in this wonderful new campus as senior students, and have successfully navigated senior cycle, making it to today. As the saying goes, there's a first time for everything, and the class of 2023 witnessed the majority of them. This year's graduating class has shown great persistence and strength throughout all their studies, and suffice to say that they have a lot to remember about their time here. We are very proud of you all, and today is a wonderful opportunity to celebrate this great achievement. I would like to extend a warm welcome to our guests of honour, our Board of Management Chairperson, Tony Brazel, former teacher at Cláis na Cuarán, Eileen Lohan, Richard O'Donoghue, TD, and former year head to our graduating class, Joe Farrell, and former teacher, Margaret Crowley. Without further ado, we will now begin our ceremony with some music performed by the school choir and soloist, sixth year, Hannah O'Mara, singing The Climb. Under the direction of Fergal Moore, accompanied by Miss Una Feehan on piano, Kieran Wall and Killian Moore on guitar, and on to the cajon, Ryan Kelly.
Make feels lost with no direction.
done, everyone. I'd now like to invite the chairperson of the Board of Management, Mr. Tony Brazel, to say a few words.
Thanks very much, Mary Kate. Ladies and gentlemen, of all the events in the school in any given year, this is definitely the red letter day. It's a great opportunity for me as chairman of the Board of Management to address not just the graduating students, but the parents and the teachers on this happy day for all of us. This class has been fortunate in the senior cycle of getting the benefit of this new school, this new building. All of you know from your early years when you came to Croom the difficulties you had in rather second-class prefab buildings which didn't meet the purpose, but unfortunately that was how it was. It's a great tribute to everyone that we've arrived here in this spanking new building which has facilities we never dreamed of even 5 or 10 years ago. The Board of Management is made up of people of different backgrounds, and I'm delighted to welcome Deputy Richard to today's meeting to join with us in this celebration. The occasion for the Board of Management to intervene in anything in the school is usually a last-minute situation. The Board of Management's job is to ensure the ethos of the school and the smooth running of the event. We don't have any problems in that because the school is very well managed by Mr. Sullivan, and really we're so proud of what is done. I think as schools go, and I've served on a few with Joe on other schools, this has been a model of how a school should run, how it should operate. I want to say a thank you to the parents for delivering their and having the foresight to enroll their children in the school here, because there was a time, you know, you could go to many schools. As a result of the last few years here, it's not easy to get into Croom anymore. On the last run for next year, we filled the quota on the first call, which is a simple sign of a vote of confidence by everyone to send their children here. We've also a special thing to say to the students. You've seen the two worlds. You've seen the prefab world and you've seen the real world. I, some months ago, brought Professor Conan from TUS to visit the facility, and he was just gobsmacked at how good the facilities and the range of them and the opportunity to do everything. When special schools and special classes were not compulsory, we in turn here have two going on a third class for next September. We met the challenge of biodiversity. We all hear of the need for us to do various things. What school in Ireland has 3,500 trees planted in the last 12 months? So, you know, we've ticked all the boxes and we've done all the right things. And lastly, I want to say, none of this would happen without the support, the active support of the teaching community. You see a lot of, you know, results of various activities that the school has been participating in. Most of that has been done with the voluntary hours of the teachers and the fact that they've been so interested in what they do, they give up their hours. And you can see today with the music session under Fergal, it's a great testimony of the spirit within the school. So, you know, as chairman of the board, I'm very, very happy to say, first of all, welcome to everyone, but also to say that we want to wish a farewell to our outgoing graduating class. Just a little reminder that don't forget the school when you've left here. You're always welcome. When you get into positions of importance, you might even think of helping out the school with sponsorships or whatever. You're going into a time when opportunity is at its optimum. You've seen the 1 billion chemical outfit coming to Raheen. You've seen last week the 400 million that Analog were putting into the facility also in Raheen. And you're just graduating at a time when, you know, those jobs will be coming on stream in the next 2 or 3 years. As regards education, whilst this is your graduation day, don't let it be the last day that you've been involved in education. People will say every day you're learning, every day you're being educated. But if you want to make progress, your next step is a third level education, whether it's daytime or nighttime. It has to be done. And again, we're so fortunate here in the Limerick area. We have no less than 3 third level institutions. You have Mary Eye, you have TUS, and you have UL. And there's great opportunity for, you know, a range of different interests to be catered for that. So you're coming into a good time. The country has now apparently full employment. So whatever you choose to do, you will find it that you'll have a good opportunity to not only live locally, but to work locally as well. So with those few words, I say congratulations on your graduation. Thanks to the parents. Thanks to the teachers, because this is your result, and a happy graduation day to all of you. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Brazel. I'd now like to invite Deputy Principals, Ms. Evelyn Canty and Mr. James O'Tottensey, to the stage, please.
Good afternoon, everyone. It wasn't my plan to be up here today, so I'm just going to say some words on behalf of Mr. O'Sullivan. Parents, colleagues, and especially our wonderful graduating class of 2023, I am truly sorry and very disappointed to be missing the celebration of this wonderful occasion. Unfortunately, I need to be with my family as we are addressing an urgent family emergency. These are days that fill us all with pride. Today is one of them. Ours is a shared pride with your parents, families, and all who are invested in each of you. Congratulations and thank you all for the many, many occasions that you have given us to be proud of each and every one of you. You should all be proud of yourselves today on this occasion of your graduation. I came across a wonderful and fitting quote in recent days that will give you all something to ponder as you imagine your happy and successful futures. Success is not the key to happiness. Happiness is the key to success. Happiness is a choice. Be content with what you have. It's a key to happiness. Don't tie happiness to success. They're not always linked. Aim high, but stay grounded. Ambition and contentment can coexist. Success is not the key to happiness. Happiness is the key to success. Take a moment to savor this wonderful moment, this rite of passage, the teachers that have inspired you, and the friendships that will endure. You are at a very special time in your lives, and you now graduate to the bright futures that lie ahead for each of you. It is my hope that you will all carry fond memories of your time with us forever. Enjoy the memories. Today, you become alumni of Cailleacht Chiron. We will follow each of your futures with interest. Congratulations and well done to you all.
Unfortunately, ChatGPT went offline before I had to write this speech, so this is actually my own words, unfortunately, so bear with me. So ladies and gentlemen, parents, colleagues, particularly former colleagues, Mr. Farrell, your former year ahead, Ms. Eileen Lohan, Ms. Margaret Crowley, Mr. Brazel, Chair of the Board of Management, and Mr. O'Donoghue, and in particular, students. And it's fantastic to see such an array of former students here. I would like to take the time to thank all the people who made not just today possible, but your entire journey through Cailleacht Chiron. To our admin staff, Joanne and Margie at the back of the room, a huge thank you to Tom, Brendan, Nuala and Kira for all their hard work in preparing the school for today. Thank you to the Parents' Council for their help in preparing for this occasion and making and serving all the refreshments, gathering the decorations, plants and flowers you see here on the stage. Today's ceremony has only been made possible by the hard work of a number of people. So I think at the end of this, a big round of applause must go to Mr. Fergal Moore, Ms. Karen Bowles, Ms. Mary Kate Hanley, and in particular, Dean Mr. Cullum Hanley. Well done. A huge thank you must go to you, the parents and the families, who have supported the school and staff over the last 6 years and entrusted us with your sons and daughters. And what's in particularly fantastic to see is the number of former students that are here and that you have entrusted us with multiple children. I look over at the O'Maras who are now finally done after, what is it, about 10, five kids in about 10 years, so fantastic. Thank you to the entire teaching staff of Clos Chiron who are gathered here today, who have helped shape you into the young men and women you are today. I ask each of the students to really take time to remember all those teachers who gave their time inside and outside of school. Those that sat with you through the hard times, many of you in my office, and those of you that celebrated with you your pride and achievements and enjoyed the good times with you. And that leads me to the biggest thank you, which must go to you, the graduating class of 2023. You've made the journey with us from prefab to luxury, from COVID masks to great big smiles we see today, and from innocent first years to amazing, talented and gifted young women here before us today. Today is not only a celebration of you and your families, but is a celebration of the school community that I believe is like no other. It is my hope that today and in the days ahead, you are reminded of the endless possibilities and opportunities you are afforded here in Clos Chiron. From academic expectations to curricular options and sporting, creative, musical, artistic, scientific, linguistic, practical, technological and social opportunities. I hope it is, and it is the hope of any good school, that you will look back with pride and happiness on your time here with us. So before I finish, I want you to make me a few promises. Always try your best and live the best life you can. Make a difference, even if it's changing the life of just one person. Take care of yourself and those around you. Spend a lifetime learning and seeking knowledge, and enjoy every moment that life gives you. Look out for each other. Every one of you here today are connected forever as the family of Clos Chiron and the class of 2023. And as Mr. Brazel said, don't be embarrassed to come back to us and ask us for help. We'll always be here as long as you need us. I want you to leave you with some final words, which I used at my own graduation many years ago. Today, we are throwing our caps in the air, getting ready to go different ways, to tackle the world head on, my friends, and to start on the very first phase of adult life with all it implies. No more running home to mom, but making her proud of the lives we lead and showing our dads we're not done. So today we sit in this great big hall. We'd like to give our thanks to you all for being there when we needed you. Now it's our turn to show you what we can do. I don't know how or why or when, but goodbye, my friends, until we meet again.
Thank you. That was beautiful. I'd now like to call on your dean, Mr. Cullum Hanley, for you to receive your graduation medals.
Thank you very much. So listen, you'll be hearing and seeing a lot of me for the day, so I'll be talking to you formally in a while, but we're here now at this particular part of the ceremony to deal with the most important people, obviously, and to give them their moments that they've been waiting for and they richly deserve. So what we're going to do, guys, is go class by class. You're sitting in order according to what's going to work for this, not necessarily what's meant to work for the way in. Put my hand up on that one, sorry about that. But we are going to go class by class, okay? So I'm going to ask Miss Canty to make her way over here. Rachel and the TYs will be ready with your certificates, your medals, your scrolls, so everything inside in the one bag, okay? Just for the functioning of it, okay? So as you call out class by class, your tutors will come up with you and you just follow in alphabetical order and loop back in. Is that okay? So can we give a massive, massive round of applause for our first graduating class today, which is Class Cusick. First up is Nazir Ahmed Saeed. You can all stand up, guys. Class Cusick, stand up. Irene Castillon. Ansel Mary George. Mikhail Gagloza. Teresa Grigoletto. Abby Keane. Nadine Kandoe. Jordan Lenehan. Riam Gabiev. Nathan Ndlovu. Gladys Pembele. Scott Quinn Daly. Yana Salamatina. Mantas Stazinas. Gabriele Schmacka. And Kieran C. Well done, guys. Well done, guys. So I'd now like to call on the choir and a performance by Nicole Connolly and Nadine Kandoe singing Night Changes.
Disappear.
Well done, guys. Fantastic stuff again. So, I'd now like to call on Jack Daly. If Jack can come to the stage, please. He's going to give you a little speech on his memories from the junior cycle. So, a round of applause for Jack, please. Good.
Good afternoon, everyone. I am very honoured to be tasked today with recounting our year group's journey through an eventful first to third year. It is extremely difficult to comprehend where all the time has gone, as today marks the end of our term in Chailc Chiaráin. We have each our own experiences from our time here, and so I aim to give you, to remind you all of some of these key milestones we all experienced together. First year was a time that now seems a distant memory. Obviously, our first day of school was a memorable occasion for each of us as we took photos at home in front of the good wall. Packing our bags to the brim with everything we thought we might need, we were crammed into an old school assembly where we were paired off into our new base classes by our year head, Mr. Joe Farrell. These base classes would soon become a big group of friends that made us excited to come into school every single morning. Our sole trip in first year was to the Beat the Young Scientist competition in Dublin. It was a vastly eye-opening experience as to the possibilities of what could be achieved through school, whether we had an interest in science or not. Although, along with this science exhibition, Funderland struck a happy medium amongst our year group as we enjoyed our first school day out with our new friends. Extracurricular activities were, for many of us, the highlight of our junior cycle. Our first year soccer team remains a topic of conversation to this day as we shared the pitch with friends on numerous occasions with some great performances. As well as this, our teams in both basketball and GAA gave us all the opportunity to be involved in sport. A special thank you must go to all the teachers who dedicated their time for us to benefit us on their own accord. As first year came to an end, we look forward to second year. Bag sizes began to shrink and skin tones became an indescribable shade of orange. Having now shaken, being the youngest in the school, we felt invincible. Little did we know we still had so much to learn. With second year came our sole successes in school sport, as our senior Camogie team and boys intermediate hurlers both won honours respectively, with some of our still young year playing parts in each team. Most notably, however, must be our second year burn trip. An overnight stay in the rural town of Love, Lynx Africa was well packed, many of us in the mood for matchmaking. We enjoyed a range of activities over the course of our 2 days. No sooner than we had arrived, our presence was truly felt in the Imperial Hotel Liston Varna, as a door, sink and toilet were amongst the early casualties. We devoured a well-needed meal before the iconic Burn Disco. A few extracurricular activities also ensued, although not to the knowledge of any teachers. As we looked forward to our junior cert, study became a tangible concept for us all. Although we eventually never had to sit it, thanks to the best Good Friday agreement since 1998. A 2 weeks off, which eventually turned out to be much longer, we logged on to Zoom classes from the comfort of our own beds. A truly surreal time we can all say we lived through together under the stewardship of our past year head, Mr. Farrell. I sincerely hope we can all look back on our time in years to come with the fondest of memories from our junior cycle. Thank you.
Well done, Jack. Good lad. Fair play. So, we're now going to move on to Class Kavanagh. Now, we're going to do a slight change this time. We didn't send a member to shock, so we'll clarify this afterwards. Well, should you go back and sit down in your seats again, we'll take the class photographs afterwards outside, if that's okay. Thank you. What we'll do is, again, Ms. O'Brien is going to come up, Ms. Canty is going to head up here again, and in alphabetical order, I'll call you out to the stage. So can you give a massive round of applause to Class Kavanagh, please? So first up, we have Sasha Berry. Rami Chumo. Shannon Daly. T. Clara D'Andrade. Dasha Gruznova. Oscar Gutierrez Roman. Sebastian Yabinski. Amy Kelly. Emer Leonard. Bart Mawiska. Killian Moore. Josh Morrissey. Nathaniel Nivchas. Carolina Rodak Frick. Tamara Rousier. Anna Ryan Frutos. Annika Sheehan. Keta Skidnitz. Natalia Skorkowska. Guillerme Sobral Alberque. And Martina Vance. Once again, a huge, huge round of applause for Class Kavanagh, please, and their tutor, Miss Amy O'Brien. So, we move on to Mr. Bushell's class, which is Class Meig, and the same format as the last guy. So, we give a massive round of applause to Class Meig, please. So, first up, we have Faisal Adebimpe. Ainsley Alabi. Maisie Amaze. Michael Anglum. Evan Bedford Grant. Cahill Bennett. Aidan Classy. Rian Cooper. Cahill Cross. Jack Daly. Mike Daly. Jason Mees. Connor Nash. Alex O'Brien. Kira O'Carroll. Hannah O'Mara. Luke Pinder. Cahill Reid. Kelly Roach. And last but not least, although he's always late, Mark Ruddle. Well done, guys. So once more, guys, as they make their way down to the seats, can you give a huge, huge round of applause to Mr. Butcher's class, Class May. I'm now going to call on... You're okay. You can. I'm now going to call on Natalia Kishembe, please, to come up and talk about their senior cycle experience.
Good afternoon, family, friends, teachers, and of course, fellow graduates. Today officially marks the dawn of a new chapter as we acknowledge the closing of the last one. It is an honor to stand before you all on this special day as we share our laughter and tears as we reminisce on the times we spent in Coláiste Cáirán. Many of us grew up on American television adaptations of secondary school, from the unrealistic science lessons that solely involved blowing things up and not at all calculations and definitions, to dozens of tight-knit high school cliques. Unfortunately, only the latter was true. Though many of us spent the first few years in our separate circles, detached from one another, there were moments we shared as a year that we will forever cherish as we grow. We essentially began our senior cycle in an apocalyptic world. I mean, come on, who would have thought our generation would experience a global pandemic? Half of us thought the end days were upon us. We counted down the days until the school gates would welcome us once again, while simultaneously praying we could revert to the days in which we slept during our Zoom classes. Regardless of our scattered emotions, we returned with a united fashion sense, the masks. COVID tried to stunt us as a group, and in some ways it did. We didn't have an authentic transition year like the previous years had. However, we made the most of the opportunities that were afforded to us. The fact that we refrained from self-pity and instead found humor in the midst of chaos is testament to our determination to overcome adversities. This is a trait that will continue to serve us as we embark on new journeys. When the masks permanently came off in fifth year, we had to reintroduce ourselves to each other. It was like we had never met before. Everybody had changed in a way. The first few weeks of normality felt unfamiliar. For many of us, the atypical life we adapted to during the pandemic became our comfort. Needless to say, we struggled hard. We had a chunk of our adolescence stolen from us, and before we knew it, it was sixth year, and the only words that were ever uttered to us were the leaving cert. We may not be the best of friends, but the genuine support we have shown each other is admirable. We fought, we hugged, we laughed, we cried, but we did it together. As much as we hate to admit, over the years we've been taught important values, particularly in our senior cycle, which we may not have understood in our earlier years, such as teamwork, resilience, and most importantly, the significance of community. No matter where the journey of life takes us next, we should always be proud to be a part of the community that helped shape us into the individuals we are today. Many of us revel in the joy of removing the crippling grey uniforms, but among us are those who desperately cling to the familiarity and dread the thought of leaving it behind. Know that your fear is valid. Quoting Dr. Seuss, a cartoonist and author prevalent in our childhood, don't cry because it's over, smile because it happened. We shouldn't let the fear of failing discourage us as we face unfamiliar challenges. Instead, we should recognize that these challenges are merely opportunities disguised as disappointment and embarrassment, opportunities that should be embraced and viewed as central to our development as fully fledged individuals. As we long for a life without difficulties, remember that oak grows strong in contrary winds and diamonds are made under pressure. Even flowers cannot blossom without rain. We entered Kalashtra Karan as saplings, and each year we grew. For the past 3 years, we've worked to the best of our abilities despite the obstacles thrown in our path. On behalf of the graduates, I would like to acknowledge the man behind the curtains, Mr. Hanley, who ensured that we settled for nothing but the best for ourselves. We are forever indebted to you for the sincerity and patience you have shown us throughout the years. With your help, we have blossomed into the young adults ready to face the world. I wish everyone great success in their future endeavors. Let today be a reminder of our commitment and dedication. Congratulations to the class of 2023. We did it.
Well done, Italia. Thanks a million. You're far too kind with your words, but I do appreciate them. Thank you. Okay, we're going to move on to the next class. So this is moving on to Mr. Bennett's group. And we have some absolute legends in this group. So I would ask the same thing, Ms. Canty, to come up, and we'll have it ready, and Mr. Bennett will come along, and we'll call you out in order. Can give a massive round of applause first, please, and welcome Class Hume to be graduated. First up, we have Husna Abedzai. Jordan Benson Gimo. Megan Carey. Luke Hayes. Charlotte Malone. Adam O'Connor. Adam Ryan. Jamie Ryan. And TJ Tierney. Well done, guys. Another huge round of applause for Class Hume and Mr. Bennett. So, we're on to our final group. This is Mr. Crowley's base class and his class Parks. So we give him a massive round of applause to class Parks, please. First up, we have Michelle Bennis. Cahill Casey. Nicole Connolly. Connor Daly. Are we sure? Tom Delahunty. William Doerr. Tracy Eero. Angel Easy. Colum Griffin. May Griffin. I'm going to let the next one sink in for a second. Jamie Hannon. Well done, Jamie. Jane Jones. Natalia Kishembe. Joe Kelly. Alex Liu. Chris Lyons. Junior Mananga. Moise Malik. Luke Murphy. Gracie O'Brien. Abby O'Gorman. Moby Offer. Vimbai Sheehan. Kaylee Toomey. And finally for this year, Kieran Wall. Well done, guys. And again, finally, one massive round of applause for Mr. Crowley and Class Parks. Congratulations.
Thank you, Mr. Hanley, and congratulations, everyone. We will now have another musical interlude from our choir and soloist Tracy Eero singing Concede Me, accompanied by Una Feehan.
Una volta forse non l'è stato mai.
That was gorgeous. Well done, everybody. I would now like Hannah O'Mara, come back. I'd now like Hannah to come up here to the stage, and she's going to reflect on her time here at Colossae Curon.
When I was approached by Mr. Hanley to write this speech, my initial reaction was one of pure panic, which slowly morphed into nervousness. I sat down for hours on end, mulling over what I could possibly say that would truly pay my school experience justice. Not too far into the process, I realised I couldn't. My words could never capture what each of us here has gained from our individual journeys at Colossae de Curon. That's one of the best things about this school. It's given us all a different life. But one thing that unifies us all is the anticipation for what our futures hold. As I walked into the daunting double doors that bless the old prefab paradise we like to call school, I knew I had signed up for anarchy. The vast majority of us trudged into that building knowing nobody. We were scared, alone, and missing the comfort of our homes. That first day, those brave young children took the initial steps towards the goal of becoming honourable young people. We came together, and through little other than unadulterated empathy, we took a leap of faith and comforted each other. Although we may never have verbalised the importance of those friendships, I know that they will prove to be worth more than any of us had bargained for. The other day, as I was scrolling through TikTok, I came across a thread of quotes entitled In Another Universe. While there were many emotional inclusions, there was one that struck me the most. In another universe, me and my high school friends are still having lunch together. From now on, nothing will be the same again. We're never going to have a lunchtime gossip session. There'll be no more bothering Mr. Hanley. And the most heartbreaking thing, we will never have another emotional talk by Finn Chambers. From now on, we might smile at each other or exchange a hug on a night out in town, but we will never get to bond over a mutual love or hatred for a teacher again. There's a reason people say these are some of the best years of your life, after all. Many schools don't fully harness their students' abilities. They constantly tell them to change who they are and the way they act. Not here, though. For the most part, our teachers have treated us like adults who are worthy of respect, while also believing in our ability to make a true and meaningful imprint on this world. As some of you may know, I'm the youngest of five kids, all of whom have attended this school. My family just love it so much that they've been a part of six different graduations, today marking the end of their journey too. I will say, I remember filling out the application form in sixth class to apply here. None of my friends had put Croom on their list. I didn't have much choice in that matter, and I wouldn't change that choice for the world. Being here, watching you all grow into the incredible people you are, has been an honour. While there were definitely hiccups along the road, a lot of which were mentioned by my classmates, we have shown resilience, forgiveness, and acceptance. And although I may not verbalise it often, being friends with you all and attending this school was one of the greatest things I have ever been forced to do. So as I conclude one of the best speeches ever delivered in CCO history, I would like to say thank you to a few people. To our parents for forcing us to come here every day, Fergalicious and the choir for helping make this ceremony a bit less boring, Tom, Brendan, Nuala and Kira for putting all of this together, the graduation committee for dealing with our onslaught of questions, Mr. O'Shaughnessy, thank you for always letting me help with the yearbook when really I just wanted to dodge maths. Mr. Hanley, thank you for being there for all of us and for listening to us complain about everything. Most importantly, I would like to say a big thank you to you all, to all of my classmates, for showing up, for school, and for each other. So before I conclude this, I would also like to send my condolences to the staff and students at CCO for losing the best group of students ever. So as Miss Coleman would say, we are at the Champions League final, so we better go out and smash it.
Well done, Hannah. Some lovely words there. Now, another performance from our choir. Now they're going to perform Halo with the solo performance from Kaylee Toohey. Everybody, that was fun. Okay, and now for the moment you've all been waiting for, the student awards. Before I begin, I would like to say that there are many awards being presented this afternoon, and it has taken many hours and much debate to arrive at the final list of recipients, which is absolutely testament to the caliber of students you all are. Our awards cover a wide-ranging area of education and achievement. They mark the deep respect held by staff for the ability of the individual students. These pupils exemplified the meaning of being a true overall master of their respective subject, and for that, we applaud them. We begin with the English Award. The Senior English Award recipient is a student with the most complete ability in the world of literature and composition. They have consistently displayed an inordinate ability and aptitude in the field of the English language. And the English prize goes to Ansel Mary George. Well done, Ansel. Now we have our Senior Irish Award. Bruntar Gradam Sheen Shrock Naguilga, Yalta Lakomas Intok, Agasphere Gro, Dardianga Nashunta. Rinna an dalta seo a cheach níhil in nach éon gné den cuasa le lena chuid ama an seo i goláiste cirán. Dibrig an dalta seo go díon díchealach ar a ghuelga scríofa agus ar a ghuelga láratha. Brontar gradam na ghuelga ar William Doar. Well done, William. Now for the Senior Maths Prize. This prize is awarded to the student who has shown a superb mathematical ability. This student has consistently performed and displayed an understanding of the world of problem solving throughout their school life. And the Senior Maths Prize goes to Mantis Stasnias. Well done, Mantis. Now the Senior Modern Language Awards. The Senior Modern Language Award is awarded to students who have displayed a flair for French, Italian, Spanish, and German. These students have consistently worked diligently to achieve their full potential in their chosen language. First, we have French and Senior French. Félicitations, Tracy Iro. Well done, Tracy. Senior Italian, congratulazioni, Cahill Bennett. Well done, Cahill. Senior German, gut gemacht, Jack Daly. Well done. And finally, Senior Spanish, felicidades, Teresa Grigoletto. Well done, everyone. Now we have Home Economics. The recipient of our Senior Home Economics Award has been a fantastic role model for this subject. She has worked with diligence for the past 2 years and is most deserving of this acknowledgement. The award goes to Michelle Bennis. Now for engineering. The Senior Engineering Award is given for dedication to the world of engineering throughout 6 years here at Coláiste Cíoráin. The recipient has been focused on all three areas of the course. A number of worthy candidates were in contention for this award, but the winner is Ainsley Alabi. There's still a few perpetuals. Yeah. Now for design and communication graphics. This award is for the students' all-round ability to perform at a very high level and to foster a positive attitude towards the subject. This award is in recognition of the hard work and positive attitude displayed over the past 2 years. Congratulations, Nathaniel Niquas. Well done. Now for construction studies. For six-year construction studies, there are many candidates worthy to be considered for this award, as there has been many considerable improvement throughout this year. The student who has been chosen has demonstrated overall excellence in technical drawing, theory, practical, and has completed all homework and project work on schedule, as well as being a pleasant and cheerful member of the class. The Construction Study Award goes to Luke Pinder. Construction studies. Okay. Now we have the Margaret Crowley Business Award. And Margaret is here with us today. This goes to a student that shows great initiative, business acumen, and determination to do well. He has performed consistently well in business since first year, demonstrating an excellent knowledge and understanding of business and accounting. And the award goes to Moise Malik. Now for geography. Geography is the study of places and the relationships between people and their environments. This award is for a geographer who has shown that they can explore both the physical properties of Earth's surface and the human society spread across it. They have also demonstrated that they can examine how human cultures interact with the natural environment and the way that locations and places can have an impact on people. Our Senior Geography Award recipient is Abby Keane. And now we have our Physics Award. This student has shown great interest and enthusiasm for physics. They have demonstrated great effort to excel in this subject with well-deserved results. Well done to Mike Daly. John Mike. Now for the Applied Maths Award. The Applied Maths Award goes to a student who has shown particular talent and mathematical skill. He shows huge commitment to the subject and has worked hard at developing excellent problem-solving skills. And the award goes to Oscar Duterres Roma. Well done. Now we have biology. The following student contributes positively to all aspects of the subject of biology. They have positive relationships with students and teachers alike. They have an outstanding work ethic and display exemplary discipline and determination. Our Senior Biology Award goes to Dasha Groznova. Well done, Dasha. Our next award is for effort and engagement in chemistry. The winner of this award has been extremely dedicated to their studies. They've been diligent and disciplined throughout the course and has maintained a very high standard in all aspects of their work. And the winner is Maisie Amiz. Next is our Computer Science Award. To succeed in this subject, students need to be a good problem solver with a measure of resilience. This generation of computer scientists will shape the technology we will use every day. The winner of this award is a student who is diligent and innovative and has produced work of the highest standard. This student is Scott Daly. Now for politics and society. The Award for Excellence in Politics and Society is presented to the student who has demonstrated steadfast application to critical analysis, reflection, and the contextualisation of social and political issues. This student is to be commended for their passionate dedication to the field, their assiduous pursuit of objectivity, and their exemplary conduct in academic discourse. The 2023 Award for Excellence in Politics and Society is presented to Moby Offer. Well done, Moby. Now we have our Senior Art Award. This is for the student that has invested a huge amount of time, effort, creativity, and determination to improve their skill set and standards for senior art. And the award goes to Anika Sheehan. Well done. Now we have our contribution to STEM. Now, we have three students who have brought great success to the school this year. In the VEX Robotics competition, they were crowned tournament champions and received the excellent award at the Midlands Finals, qualifying for the National Finals. The National Finals were extremely competitive and the students reached the semi-finals where they were ultimately defeated. The students won the Munster Regionals in the prestigious CANSAT competition and went on to win the National Finals. This summer, they'll be travelling to Granada in Spain to represent Ireland at the international competition. A huge amount of time, effort and technical nous has been required to compete in these competitions. These competitions utilise all the skills of STEM as the students design, build and analyse their robots and satellites. The future is bright for them as the skills developed in STEM are highly sought after and will continue into the future. Well done to our contribution to STEM Award recipients, Oscar Gutierrez Roman. Yeah. Nathan Englobu. And Mikhail Balgloza. Now it's history. For his in-depth knowledge and incessant inquisitiveness, this award goes to a student most deserving of our history award. His wonderful grasp of the subject allied to his immense interest means that the history award goes to Josh Morrissey. Senior Music Award. During their time at Coláiste Chiron, this next student has shown tremendous commitment to the music department. Their efforts and willingness to contribute positively has not gone unnoticed. They too have been involved in the school show and choir over the last 6 years, while also studying and excelling at composition, theory and harmony, and always contributing positively to their class. We wish them the very best in their future studies. Our Senior Music Award goes to Emer Leonard. Don Emer. Well done. Now we have our overall contribution to the musical and the arts. Cláiste Chiarán is known for its amazing musical productions. Each year, we require students to give up a huge amount of their time to take part, and we are so lucky to have such talented students in our midst. This award goes to the student who has contributed greatly in every aspect of the school musical over the years and represents someone who has shown dedication to the arts. This particular student has been involved in many school productions, performing at various school events both as a soloist and as a member of the school choir. They have given their time to every aspect of the arts at Cláiste Chiarán, and we are very excited to see what the future has in store for this student. The overall contribution to musical and the arts award goes to Hannah O'Mara. Well done, Hannah. I'd now like to invite Mr. Colm Hanley to present the remaining awards.
Thanks very much, Mary-Kate. So, we're on to the last few awards of the day, guys. And again, just a huge congratulations to everybody who's taken home awards today. It's truly a remarkable achievement and a worthy recognition of the time that you spent here and all that you put into it. So, I'll get straight to it. The first of the awards that I have the absolute pleasure of presenting today is the Brendan McElduff Victor Ludorum Best Overall Male Sports Star. There's a lot of candidates for this, and I mean this in all sincerity, and obviously this is one that's very close to my own heart too, but there's no doubt the winner of this award is massively deserving, as he represents his county, he represents his school, he's represented his school in many, many, many different disciplines over the years, and he's an overall just a brilliant young fella. Your sports male star of the year is William Doerr. Huge round of applause for Will, please. Thank you. In the run-up to today, the students were kind of under the impression that I decided these awards. I can assure you I did not. It's a massive effort on behalf of all the staff, and especially a huge thanks to Mary-Kate standing behind me, and today her helper, obviously Ava. Give me a huge round of applause for coordinating all this in today, please. And with that came lots of protests and pleas for me to give people awards for this, that, and the other. And this next winner, she basically threatened my life a few times. She didn't get an award today and various things, and she wasn't alone there. This is not why she's receiving this award, though. She's receiving this award because she's an outstanding young woman. She's contributed massively to sport in this school over the last 6 years, and the worthy winner of this is Miss Kaylee Toomey. Huge round of applause for Kaylee again, please. Thank you. The next award goes to our overall contribution to the LCA programme. We are very, very fortunate to have under the stewardship of Mr. Bennett a really, really good group of kids in this class this year. Really good, honest, decent people, and I'm exceptionally proud to be associated with each and every one of you, and I mean that. The winner of the award this year, though, is a young man who I find it really, really hard to do justice to just how good a human being this guy is. I've taught for 15 years here. It's very, very, very hard to define just how excellent this child is. He's represented the school and captained the school in sports and sporting occasions, and the massively worthy winner of the contribution to the LCA program for this year is the legend that is TJ Tierney. Again, a huge round of applause for TJ. Well done. So, there's two more awards. This next award is in honour of this unbelievable woman sitting down here in front of us. When I started here, Eileen Lohan was an integral part of the staff, and even in her retirement, and it's testament to all that she's done, we've named the award after her because Eileen is one of the most generous, kind, caring people I've ever met, and I'm sure every staff member here will agree. So can first of all give a huge round of applause to Miss Eileen Lohan. And each year we give an award in Eileen's honour to a student who personifies, exemplifies and shows all of those attributes I just mentioned. Kindness, caring, a person who just looks out for other people, puts other people first and always, always, always has a smile on her face. The winner of this year's Eileen Lohan Award, gives me massive pleasure to announce this, is Hannah O'Mara. And finally, our final award of the day and of the year is our Senior Principal's Perpetual Cup, our Student of the Year. With a group like this, there's so many candidates. And again, I want to thank all the teachers for putting forward so many names in each of their subject areas of worthy winners of all the different awards today. But of all of the children here, one name kept popping up again and again and again. And again, it's a young man who has represented the schools on so many different levels, be it sporting, hurling particularly. He's a good crew man, a good Limerick man, and a massively worthy winner of Clostic Cuaran Student of the Year for 2023. Can you give a huge, huge round of applause for Mr. Jack Daly? Well done, Jack. One massive round of applause again, please. And for all of the winners of our awards today. That concludes our awards. I'd now like to call on the choir and Emer Leonard, winner of our music award this year, to sing us a song. So round of applause for the choir as they make their way over, please.
She keeps on growing, slipping through my fingers all the time. Some of that we did, but most we didn't. And why, I just don't know. Slipping through my fingers all the time, I tried to capture every minute, the feeling in it. Slipping through my fingers all the time, do I really see what's in her mind? Each time I think I'm close to knowing, she keeps on growing. Slipping through my fingers all the time. Sometimes I wish that I could freeze the picture and save it from the funny tricks of time. Slipping through my fingers.
Well done, Emer. Fabulous as always. Well done. Okay, so I suppose I better say a few words. You'll forgive me, I won't be overly formal, because today is all about these children here in front of us, and I'm sure you agree they're phenomenal. So guys, today marks the end of your formal journey here with us at Clonsty Cuarán. For the vast majority of you, it began up the road under the care and guidance of Mr. Joe Farrell, who I'm delighted has joined us here today. And just one more time, Joe, on behalf of myself, you did an amazing job with these kids. By the time I took them over, to be honest, I've had very little to do for the last 3 years. So the foundation you laid with them was absolutely incredible. They're house trained, most of them. So listen, a huge round of applause for Joe and all the work he did. I really appreciate it. To my 6 years, there'll be no talk of academics today. No talks of study planners. No talk of CAO. I promise I won't pull Finn out of Crowley's office there and surprise you, and none of that type of stuff. Today is all about yourselves, and I want to talk about my experience with ye and how grateful I am to have spent these last 3 years with ye. You're an incredible group of kids, and genuinely it's been the privilege of my teaching career to spend the last 3 years with ye. I want to put a bit of context to this. I'm an English teacher, that's what we do. So basically, the primary function, as I see it, of any school is to educate. But at times I feel the term education isn't fully understood. Yes, homework and all the things that go with it, CEO and so on, they're massively important and they are valued here. I can assure you of that. And they're encouraged every day. However, what's equally, and in my opinion, more important, is the social and emotional development of our kids. And they're in our care, and it's hugely important that we recognize that. I fully believe that the staff, management, and everyone involved in this school puts that first, and I'm delighted, and that's the reason I'm so proud to stand here before you today as your six-year dean, because I know that's the most important thing to you too. Watching you develop from naive, impressionable children to the ambitious, confident young adults who sit here today is why us teachers are in such a privileged position. Of course, you've made countless mistakes along the way, and you'll continue to make those mistakes until you're old and grey and slightly larger like myself, but that's all part of the deal. You leave here today equipped for life beyond this building. You'll fail at times, but so long as you keep valuing failure, and we spoke a lot about this, and learning from setbacks, everything will end up just fine. All really will be well. So what makes this place so special? And the simple answer again is you people. Kids here, the kids there, kids everywhere inside in this building, they're absolutely phenomenal. And ye are the best representation of that. Obviously, I'm biased, but I agree with Hannah, ye are the best group to ever leave this school. You come from different backgrounds, different skills, different talents, different aspirations, very different temperaments, but you all share a common decency. And that makes me incredibly proud again to be associated with ye. The other day, Miriam Cassidy, as she does, caught me a little bit off guard. I was inside in the staff room on whatever morning. What did we send him home? Monday? Tuesday morning. And she asked me, was I lonesome without my 6 years? The truthful answer is, I absolutely was. So what did I think about after? I said, well, what do I miss most? I'll miss a lot, but I tried to put it down a few little memories that I could muster together and the things that that'll keep me going over the next few years here. First of all, getting my almost daily email from Joanne and Margie in the office explaining that Adam Ryan wanted to go home. Adam, I know what you're up to. There's no one wanted to go home that often. You're just coming down to chat the women up. I know you well. I know exactly what you're up to. Chasing Jamie Hannan around the corridors 4, 5, 6 times a day to kick him back to class. I just don't understand why you kept going by my door, because if you went the other corridor, I wouldn't have seen you. But anyway, on that note, though, I do have to pay a massive, massive congratulations to Jamie. Okay, I'm hugely proud of you, Jamie. I'm also TJ, because they've both been accepted into the FAI apprenticeship course and will go on next September to study under the stewardship of that program. So huge round of applause for you guys. I'll miss chatting with TJ about Liverpool, about this, about that and the other. He's an unbelievable young fella, and I think he's probably the embodiment of what's great about ye as a group. He's just genuine, he's kind, he's down to earth, so I'll 100% miss that. I'll miss listening to Natalia Skarkovska giving out to me about losing her English copy in second year, a claim that I absolutely refute to this day until I die. The daily chats in the senior dean's office with so many emotional teenagers about everything and anything. Most of the time, they had absolutely no idea what they're emotional about, but sure, listen, we had a chat anyway. And it gave me an opportunity to get to know them a little better. And again, I feel really privileged that I had that opportunity. Just having a crack with you, laughs, going on a few trips that we managed to get on in spite of COVID and so on. The smiling faces every day, Emer and Sasha, Tamara, every day I walked in, Amy Kelly, all these people, they're just incredible people. Looking at Tom Delahunty every morning, I'm wondering, what's he up to? And as I look down at him now, I'm wondering, what's he up to? I'm not quite sure. But Tom, again, much like TJ, I'm very, very proud that the fact that you are sitting here today and you got through it. And you will go on and you're off to New Zealand in a few months, and the very best of luck to you and fair play. Overall, lads, what I miss is the decency that pours out of you. I miss watching you support each other, and on the many occasions supporting me when I was having a bit of an off day, and putting up with me and my rants and my raves and my God knows what, my tangents, as I'm about to go into one. But my day started off, and I'll finish with this. My day started off every day here for the last 3 years, but particularly the last year, walking around about 8 o'clock. I do my loops upstairs, and I go into the various base classes. And it was always massively entertaining. I'd start with Mr. Bennett's room up the top of the corridor, where I'd be pleasantly greeted by 3 welcoming faces, Husna, TJ, and Mr. Bennett. On really special occasions, and I mean really special occasions, I'd also see the 2 Adams, Luke, Charlotte, Megan, and Jamie make an early morning appearance. But to be fair, they usually made it in time for first period, so we'll forgive them. Next, I'd stroll down the corridor to Mr. Bushell's room, where I'd always get a polite smile from Hannah, Kelly, and Kira, a welcoming and sincere good morning from Jack Daly, the gent that he is, followed by a disgruntled groan from Anglim and the rest of the lads down the back of the class. It usually took me an hour or 2 to kind of thaw out in the morning, so we didn't take it personally. My next stop would be to class Cusick, Miss McDonald's class, down in Miriam's room. There was always such a calm atmosphere in there. I'd walk in, Ansel would greet me with her fabulous smile. I'd get the occasional nod of the head from Yana or Mantis. But in general, everyone else just went about their daily routines in a perfect calmness. And it really was just a joy to behold. However, I do think the calm atmosphere is a touch too relaxing for Gabriella. Because as most mornings I walk in, she was unconscious down the back, put her head hood over her head, and wishing death on me any time I tried to disturb her. From there, I journey across the corridor into Amy O'Brien's tutorial and soak up the positivity. This room is truly where happiness lived. Amy, in the most positive way, has mammied these kids for the last 6 years. On the rare occasion when Amy was out, and they were stuck with me calling their roll, I'd be greeted by an array of genuinely concerned faces, asking frantic questions to ensure Amy was okay, and seeking reassurances that she'd be returning the following day. Amy, you created an unbelievable environment with those kids for the last 6 years. and they're very much yours. Can I give just, I don't like individual things here, but Amy is with these kids for the last 6 years. Can you give her a huge round of applause, please? Finally, I pop my head down into Crowley's group to finish off the morning. I think it's fair to say that no two mornings were ever the same here. There was either a serious gossiping session taking place, with Crowley absolutely smack in the middle of it, enjoying it every moment, a heated debate with tempers flying at times, usually involving Jane, Nicole, Kaylee, and of course, Mr. Crowley, Connor and Luke arriving freshly late, hand in hand, even though they're the closest to the school. Moby, passionately debating down the bottom corner with Talia and the other girls about the merits of the uniform. Moby is passionately in favour of a really strong uniform policy here in this school, and she lives every day by that. As all this unfolded, Thomas, May, Abby, Michelle would be frantically trying to finish last night's homework, although they always assured me that it was the extra study. I really enjoyed this class in the mornings, and I must give a massive, massive amount of credit to Mr. Crowley, who built up such an amazing rapport with those kids. I started the same day as this man in this school, okay? And before leaving, I have to acknowledge the work that he does behind the scenes. He does, like, he's not up here standing and talking, he's much happier. He's, every single day, he does stuff that people don't see in the school. He's a phenomenal human being, he's a massive asset to this school. And to the class parks, I've seen this man twice in a suit, his wedding day and today. So fair play to him and how you manage it. Can I give a huge round of applause? And before leaving that class, I optimistically, and I stress the word optimistically, asked the girls where Shadi was. Not get the answer I was hoping for, sigh a little, and then go on about my day, safe in the knowledge that my six-year kids were in good hands. I mentioned Shadi to all those kids, and there's been a few who haven't made it this far, and they've went on their own journeys, and we wish them massive, massive amount of good fortune. And for every one of them that entered the door with Joe 6 years ago, whether here today or not, on behalf of myself and everyone here, I want to wish them all huge success in the future. Yep, that's it. Before I move on to the thank yous, and I'm going to call Jane up in a second to help me with these, I just want to finish off again by thanking all of you for providing me, as I said, with the most enjoyable, memorable 3 years of my teaching career. I'm hugely, hugely proud of you. Please don't be strangers, because you'll all know where to find me if you need something. I'll be here. Thank you very much. We're almost there, guys. I know it's been a long day, but we're actually ahead of time, so we're flying it, okay? A few thank yous, and really, really important thank yous. And I'm going to ask, by just acknowledging the Grads Committee before I call Jane up. The Grads Committee, again, from the students' point of view, when they leave here, they're going to go into town, they're going to have their meal in Molly's with a few of the teachers, not in Molly's, they're going to have their meal in Vincenzo's. Some of them might be having a meal in Molly's, I don't know, but... and then on to Molly's afterwards. But the Grads Committee, headed by Ms. Jane Jones as their chairperson, organised all of that. So we give a massive round of applause to Jane and the Grads Committee. So can I get Jane to come up to the stage as well now, please, along with Michelle Bennis, Kelly Roach, Kaylee, TJ Tierney, and Adam Ryan, please. 2 seconds, Adam, good lad. So, we start lining them up there, girls, yep. So the first thank you, and a very sincere thank you I want to make, and he's not here today, unfortunately, but I do, on behalf of the graduating class, is to Mr. Juror Sullivan, our principal, okay? Juror, again, is always there, he's always behind the scenes. You never see the extent of the work that the man puts in, and I know the genuine care and affection that he has for each of you and the drive he has for this school. So Juror, he's not with us today. We wish him well, and I just want to say a sincere thank you on behalf of the whole graduating class. So please, Mr. Juror Sullivan, thank you. To his management team, and firstly to Ms. Canty. Ms. Canty took over from shocks last year in terms of the affairs of the seniors. So myself and Evelyn meet every week and have our chat. And again, much like Ger, does everything in her power to make sure that these kids have everything they need every single day. Her commitment to them and to this school is absolutely unquestioned. And on a personal note, and on behalf of all the guys here, I want to say a massive, massive thank you for all that you do. So Michelle is going to give you a little token of their appreciation. We're going to have to get Shocks put on the camera now for a second. So, Mr. O'Shaughnessy, again, I don't know how many years ago it is now, you were standing here and I was down there and all this type of stuff. I've been with Mr. O'Shaughnessy as his sidekick and ally for a long time, and this guy, I know what he does. Much like I spoke about Crowley, Ms. Canty, everyone, he does so much work behind the scenes for these kids. Okay, day in, day out, there's a revolving door in that office. And it's not for discipline issues, it's to mind them. Okay, so on behalf of myself and all of them, I have a very special sister who wants to hand you a little gift to acknowledge all the work you do. So a huge round of applause for Mr. O'Shaughnessy, please. So, I don't see him, but he better be there because I warned him. Is Tom down there? Listen, I'm sure someone will round him up here. Maybe he's hiding because he kind of got an inkling I might be doing this. But listen, our caretakers, we have a phenomenal caretaking staff here and general staff in the school. And every single day, Brendan and Tom do huge, huge work to support the kids. It's been mentioned already. And they want to give a small token of their appreciation. So is Tom down there, lads? Because we can get him afterwards if needs be. If he's not, I might move on. I will. Okay, we'll come back to that in a second. Okay, next. And they better be here because I definitely warned them. Is Joanne and Margie. Margie, turn around. No, don't be running away. Come back. Okay, every single day, lads, and every single school is blessed to have front of office staff like this. I mean, Joanne and Margie deal with all of our rubbish. No matter what type of mood we're in, they deal with it. And they genuinely, I wouldn't do any of my job without for them, okay? And in terms of the kids, anything they ever need is always, always unquestioned. They do go above and beyond. And like I said earlier, their special friend who they're going to miss terribly is going to, if they can come up here, please, and get a gift off Adam Ryan, please, before he goes. Big hug now, Adam. Amen. Thanks, Joanne. Thanks, Mary. Tom there? So, Tom, you tried to run away like the Corkleds last Sunday, but it didn't work for them, and it's not going to work for you. Okay. The man who's slowly entering the room here, again, I believe he started the same day as us, Crowley, am I right? Again, has done more than any of us, and I mean any of us, for the kids in the school for the last 15 years. There's literally nothing he won't do, and his patience, I don't know where he gets it from, especially being from Cork. It's not fitting, it's not like him. But Tom, would you mind coming up here and get a token of appreciation from Kayleigh Toomey here for all the work that you do? Come on, Tom. Are we Brendan there? No? No. We can get it after TJ. We'll start out with Brendan afterwards, okay? So, Jane, do you want to take over from here? Up you come. That's a huge round of applause. Chairperson of the Grads Committee, Jane Jones. You need me? You're good. Enjoy.
Good afternoon. On behalf of the students, I'd like to say a few thank yous to some fantastic people that helped us on our journey to this special day. Firstly, a massive thank you to the TY Future Leader students, Rachel, Ava, Kieran, Eve and Mary-Kate, for all your hard work. We will forever be the best TY's Kalosh Kieran has ever seen, but you're definitely close second. I would like to thank Miss Amy O'Brien, the longest reigning tutor who guided her students through these past 6 years. She treats every student that walks through her door with kindness and compassion, and I would like to call on Sasha Barry to show a token of our appreciation.
I'd
also like to say a special thank you to Mr. Bennett, who is taking the departure of this year's graduating class very hard, but not as hard as the tumble he took on the student versus teacher soccer match. I'd like to call on TJ Tierney to show a token of our appreciation. And to Mr. Bushell, whose class would like to thank him for the music he played for them every morning. It was greatly appreciated, especially by Michael Anglum. I would like to call on Jack Daly to present Mr. Bushell with a token of appreciation. And to Miss MacDonald, whose class were delighted to be greeted by a warm smile each morning. I'd like to call on Nadine to show a token of our appreciation. And last, but certainly not least, I'd like to thank Mr. Crowley, who over the past 3 years has taught us a Kerry man is never wrong. I can say on the behalf of our class that our debate skills have significantly improved since transition year. I'd like to call on your second favourite student, Kayleigh Toomey, to present you with a token of our appreciation. There's also two fantastic women who have played a huge role in making today happen. Miss Hanley and Miss Bowles, on behalf of our graduating class, we can't thank you enough. We have a small token of our appreciation which will be presented by Kayleigh. I'd also like to acknowledge our amazingly talented art teacher, Mr. Lowry, for filling our school with colour and creativity, such as the beautiful mural seen behind me. Here's a gift from us students to you for our appreciation. Today wouldn't be possible without the hard work and dedication of our fabulous music teacher, Mr. Moore, who put endless hours into making this day special as we are graced with the many beautiful voices of our choir and musicians. We can't begin to thank you enough. Could you join us to receive a gift to show our appreciation? I couldn't conclude today without saying a few words about the man, the myth, the legend, Mr. Colm Hanley. This past week, I've struggled to put into words how thankful we are for the constant support and encouragement since he took on the role of our year head. Mr. Hanley has gone above and beyond for each and every student seated here today. We wouldn't be here without you. From our first assembly to our 394th assembly, he somehow seemed to bore us more and more each time. Or that could have just been the resentment of the countdown getting closer. Besides all the assemblies and the wise words of Finn Chambers, his constant encouragement will leave a mark on us throughout what today becomes the start of the rest of our lives. Cláiste Chiarán is lucky to have a selfless, kind-hearted teacher walk these halls each day, and it's a sad day for us to say goodbye. On behalf of the class of 2023, we thank you immensely. We hope this gift will leave a mark of us as your kind words have left on us.
Thanks a million, Jane and everyone. Thank you so much and well done. Okay. We now move on to, we're going to do a little photo, a little slideshow. Okay, we're almost there. I know, a little slideshow for the kids and memories over the last number of years. Before we press play in it, it's been put together by you, the students, in terms of contributing all your own memories over the last number of years, and edited by our own TY, one of the future leaders, Lucy Fitzgibbon, another amazing child. It'll be accompanied by a performance by our amazing little, where is he? There he is, Harry Moriarty. He's star of the musical this year, and he will be for many, many more years. So listen, sit back, relax, and enjoy.
Puzzle, stop.
Once again, can I have a huge, huge, huge round of applause for young Harry Moriarty, our first year. So that's it. We've come to the end of our ceremony today. Again, I want to thank everybody, all the parents, everybody, all the special guests for coming here and celebrating with these amazing kids today. And before the band or the choir sing us out with Joe Kelly and We Are Young, could I get everyone else other than the graduating class to maybe take to their feet and give this fantastic group of kids one massive round of applause. Congratulations, guys. You've officially graduated.
The door closes and you feel like falling down. I'll carry you home. Tonight, we are young.
I'm not all that you got. I guess that I just thought maybe we could find ways to fall apart. But our friends are back, so let's raise a cup, 'cause I found someone to carry me home tonight. The time the bar closes and you feel like falling down, I'll carry you home tonight.